Is it worm? Oh, I sure do hope it is worm. Worm. Is it going? Worm. Is it going? Okay. It sounds like you can hear me. Okay. Okay. Live chat. Sweet. My bad. Let's look at the video. Shit. Wait. Okay. Video looks all right. Oh no, it looks fine. Alright. Epic. Oops. Oops. My bad. Fuck. Wow. I gotta warm up first. Let's do a practice run. Okay, I have to practice that. Oops. There we go. Hello. I also love this level. This level's awesome. I'm just being really bad at the ending because it's really hard to remember for some reason. Oh. I'm just warming up right now because I played for an hour earlier today and then I went and did other shit. But I got 94. Oops. That transition is like the hardest part of the entire level. I'll definitely point that out to him when I give him my thoughts. Okay. Oof. That was not... Okay, there we go. I'm getting a little warmer. I'm so bad at Wave. I literally beat Sonic Wave. How many attempts do I have? Like, a little over 1,000, I think. Maybe like 1,500? I'm not very good at memory, so that's probably like... But hey, it helps me get a little better. Oh! I am absolutely doing that from zero. I can never remember this last cube. It's so... My brain just does not want to fucking absorb the information, if you know what I mean. Like, I always forget what to do. Let's go. I've never done that before. I did it again. Nice. Yeah, my brain just fucking stops existing for a second. Oops. This ending is definitely the hardest part in the level, though. The ship is the hardest part. I don't find it too bad. I find this wave harder, but I'm bad at wave. I think the ship is objectively harder. I'm just, like, my skill set doesn't agree with the wave at all. Is that 99? Is that Saw 99? I didn't pay attention. It'd be really funny if I died there. What the f- My hand is cold. Gotta rub them together. Give your finger a good old rubbing. Get it nice and warm. Feels way better now. Nice. I've never died there from zero before. Dude, I'm gonna scream. Oh, shame. That UFO is always really weird to me. Like, sometimes they do it, sometimes they don't. Like, it's not hard. Okay. I don't even know what I died to. I mean, I'll take it, but... Okay. God damn it. Oh, I'm so good at this game. Fucking take a drink. Jesus Christ. Goofy ass death. Level's very consistent. Yeah, it is. It's just the, some of the ship transitions, that's it. The rest of it is super consistent. It's kind of a wonder how vlacc made a level this consistent. All the different types of gameplay he used. You know? Shouldn't try to talk during that UFO, it's very focus heavy for me. I guess consistency like this does come with, hold on. It comes with, memory levels. Because you have to memorize it. But yeah, you have to memorize this, so like, if you're not consistent, then I don't know what to tell you. I almost have it. Oh, trust me, I've had like 50 deaths at least at that ship. Most of them consecutive. I'm not doing very good right now because I'm talking, but that comes with streaming, so I don't really care. That's what I normally do when I'm playing levels anyway. the hour that I spent playing earlier today, I got like maybe 70 attempts in, because all of them went to the end. I didn't do it right. I did not do it right. I was supposed to double click there and my finger just didn't want to. I keep trying to let my intuition take over with this level, which won't work because it's built specifically to make it so that you can't use your intuition. That makes it more fun, I think. Makes you use your brain. I'm not even mad. Oh. My intuition is especially bad lately because, or rather, especially sharp lately in terms of me sight reading things, because I've been playing Tartarus. And I have 54 on that. I've been trying to beat it for recording. Because I forgot to record my last Tartarus, which was Rust. But I'm like relying super, super hard on intuition lately. Because in Tartarus, I just can't rely on my eyes for any of the timings. I just have to rely on what I feel the spacing should be for like the two ball timings at 60 something. Or like, is it 60 something or 72 maybe? I don't remember. But they're just so tight that I can't rely on my eyes. Shit's fucking hard. I do have the level in 2 runs, though. I'll beat it eventually. Oh my god. Let me actually focus now, though. Saw chat move, I'll look after this attempt. Ooh, that was close. Holy shit. I knew it. If I like memory levels, troll level, I'm not a fan of natural level, at least from what I can remember about it. I could be remembering poorly though, but it's all in the types of memory. Like, the memory in this level is really creative. But yeah, in terms of levels that I normally play, like, entirely skill-based levels. Because I'm actually brain dead. Another close run. Sometimes I have no idea how I survived that fucking UFO. Oh. Level reminds you of Nutrok? In that it has bright colors, I guess. The gameplay, no. I actually thought the decoration looked pretty Darnok-ish. If you can see what I mean, in that robot part. I like Darnok's decoration, so I mean. I'm surprised they got Darnok to, like, appear for the GD10 thing, because he told me that he doesn't enjoy GD at all anymore. That's why he plays other games. Well, I guess they didn't make him play the game, they just had him show up. So, whatever. Also, Nutra's fucking hard. Like, I played it. It's hard. It is really hard. It's way harder than it looks. Like, it doesn't look that hard at all, but my fucking god. And I can do levels around that difficulty. It's just, Nutra is just built in a way that hurts me. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing anymore. Dude, earlier today I was getting only runs to like 80%. What is going on? Sketchy ass UFO, my god. What? Why am I doing that now? Do I usually do streams? I used to. I used to stream on Twitch decently regularly. I'm switching over to YouTube because Twitch is fucking terrible. But I haven't had time to stream lately because of my job, which I quit. I quit a couple weeks ago, so I have more time to stream now. Granted, I do have my college major going, but I don't got no homework today. We good. I haven't had any for the past couple days, actually, because I'm ahead. I might start streaming Tartarus at some point. I don't know. Because Tartarus is one of those where I just need to be super hyper-focused. Because, again, it is fucking hard. Like, if I feel comfortable to where I can talk while playing it, then I'll stream it, but... Unless that happens, I'm gonna be playing it, off-stream. Dude. Okay, I need a break for my eyes. This level's really white. I'll come back to that in a second. I'm gonna, like, do a practice run or something. Something else. What do we got? What was this? What is this? Oh, it's Brand's level. Right. Let's do a practice run of a fucking extreme. Not recent. Let's do one I've beaten. Have I only beaten this? Have I only beaten 7 on this account? I do have list points, yes. I'm on the list for Sonic Wave. I forgot to record Rust, which is why I'm doing Tartarus. Because I didn't want to re-beat Rust. So I'm just going to beat something harder. I thought I had more extremes on this account, though. What the fart? Well, let's do a practice run of Tartarus. I am not going to... It's going to take me like 300 attempts. Because I have to focus. Okay. Dude. Okay, it's not usually this bad. Restarting. Dude. What? I mean, the beginning is the hardest part. Dude. Come on. This is just embarrassing. Oh my god. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What do. Kill. 6 clicks, that's all it is. Oh my god. Oh my. There, Christ. It is not normally that bad. This ship is quite hard, but it's, oops, but it's very doable. You just hold to the song, but... Oh! Okay, let me actually focus. Oh. No. Start. I can't do this ship unless it's from the beginning. I can't... I only know how to do this ship in one run. Except, I'm being ass right now. Dude. You just go between. You go up, you hit that. Oh my god. Ugh. Maybe I should get back to actually practicing this. Instead of, like, bullshitting with other demons. It's only been like a week. How have I gotten this much worse? Practicing Tartarus is like the, like, practice mode. Doing Tartarus in practice mode is like the worst thing ever because you have to, like, redo so many things in such quick succession. that, like, your hand just starts to fucking burn. Of course. This is the hardest thing in the level for me right here. This ship. I can still barely do it. I don't know how I passed it before. But I did. Although right now it's taking me a lot longer than normal. Oh my god. Ouch! God. Let me get into the... There we go. This entrance is the hardest part of the swing copter easily. I don't know why the fuck Cyclic was like, I have to make the hardest thing in existence, because he made the gameplay. He did that. He did this. This is his fault. I mean, okay, his original gameplay was way harder. There's this like mini cube duel where you had to jump over fucking misaligned quads. It was frame perfect on 360. Like, unironically. So. No. Which way am I? Another reason I hate practicing Tartarus. Or practice mode-ing Tartarus. I can never tell where I am on screen. Because I just spawn into red. And I have no reference of where I am supposed to be. Dude. That being said, I've fucking gotten to 100 from here. What do I think of Tidal Wave? It's ass. It's really bad. And it's Zoink verification, so you know it's gonna be terrible to play. And I've played it, and it's terrible. Dude. This UFO is like the last actually hard part in the level, I'd say. But it's mostly because of its pattern. Its pattern is really goofy. This ball is not hard, despite what I'm making it look like. This swing copter is weirdly difficult. I don't know how to describe it. But getting that, like, consistently is weird. No. What? How was I dying there? Oh. Oh. Come on. There we go. Yeah, these were the ones I was talking about like a super long time ago. These two clicks are like hard as fuck and I can't use my eyes for them. This is the hardest part of the ending for me. These like UFO clicks and straight fly after it. They're just really awkward. Oops. Dude, this part isn't even hard. What am I doing? There we go. This wave is not that bad. I'm just bad at wave. So, like... Also, fun fact. You can slide there for some reason. Forget where all of the places are. Yeah, you can slide there for some reason. Like, Zoink gave it a 7 because he's fucking Zoink. And he enjoys the worst shit ever. Like, his buffs to Acheron are some of the most disgusting things I've ever seen. What? Okay, that was probably the worst Tartarus practice run I have done in years. Fucking incredible. Let's do Sonic Whip. See, I've actually beaten this one. I'm on the list for this one. Let's see if I have fucking Tartarus syndrome with this one too. Hello, Solter. Oh yeah, I have beaten this one a few times. 3 specifically, and also Old Sonic Wave once. And then I almost beat Auditory. And then I got 32 on Swipe. Listen. The Sonic Wave ball experience. The hardest part in the level. Don't worry about it. There's a clip of me playing this from like years ago, back before I beat the level, where I die it like in that ball and I just fucking screech. No. I died to, like, the easiest part of the first wave? Come on. And then I do 49 first try? This run sucks. Piss click first try. Hate this run. What? I died to the second wave. This cannot stand. There we go. No! What the fuck? God, I am rusty. Rust? Rust jump scare? Well, how did I do 94 first try? This run sucks. This run is terrible. I hate this run. This run is ass. Anyway, back to Spearmint. You should beat this. Good level.
It is the ADHD killer, though. I've been focusing on Minecraft computer. Okay. That's fair. But, like, fun level, though. Good level. You should play it, IMO. Am I excited for 2.2? Yes. I think it'll be a really fun update. I know a lot of people don't like it, but I do. There's a couple of features I don't like. I don't like the screen effects. That stuff is kind of cringe, because it'll just hurt my eyes. But other than that, I don't really care. I think it'll be fun. People complaining about platformer mode need to grow up. Just have fun with the shit that's there. It's there for you to have fun. You don't have to cry about it. Who cares about the fucking identity of the game? The identity of the game is the fucking Impossible Game ripoff. And I personally happen to like it. Can't wait for hamster wheel levels.
Hell yeah!
I can't wait to move and not go anywhere. You have to power the generator. New solstice level, power the generator. You don't get it?
You wouldn't get it.
You wouldn't understand generator room. Oh,
Hope 2.2 has better count trigger functionality. Me too. These count triggers are kind of ass. They don't work half the time.
I still manage to use them for... you know? Anyway, I did manage to use them for the orb that predicts the future. And that didn't break, but other stuff that I use it for tends to break a lot. Isn't there like a positional thing now in 2.2 where you can like measure the position? Also, you can measure the position of the player without like making a complicated series of ship. I feel like I heard that somewhere. What? I clicked, I mean, I clicked before I left. Okay. I clicked before I landed, but I clicked. The most micro of micro clicks. Told you I can never remember that fucking ending. No, but I'll beat it this attempt, just watch. Okay. Motherfucker clicked too late. Get his ass.
Why did my brain just shut off there? Holy shit. What the fuck just happened? My vision, like, stopped seeing the game as a game. It just stopped recognizing that there was movement. That was very interesting. I love having a terrible attention span. What the fuck? I skipped it. The master of not going the correct direction. This game is just like Minecraft?
Yes.
This game is exactly... There's squares in it. I don't have to say anything else. That's all you need to know. Have I heard about the cats? Oh my god! Stop! Why can't I remember where I'm going? Eyeballs, please adjust to the screen. That would be very kind of you. Thank you. I just forgot where I was going for a second and I went on autopilot and it worked. Incredible. I should not have lived through that entire ship. I should not have lived. I should absolutely not have lived throughout that entire ship. I got very flustered by the end. Holy shit. Like, my finger was just going all over the place. God, imagine if I beat at that attempt. That'd be so fucking funny. Autopilot reigns supreme.
I stopped focusing during that UFO, but okay. I've never died there. What the fuck? That's new. Alright. Brain? I need to look away from GD for a second. Give me a minute. All right. Goodbye. Thank you. I will do my best.
I just didn't click.
I just forgot to click.
I lagged. My brain lagged. I was buffering. What the hell? How did I do that? There's an invisible slope there. What? I just clipped through it or something? I missed. Hello, welcome back, Solsta. Did you enjoy my miss? I fired and I missed. I fired and I missed. I just. Nice. Do I have level requests? Not right now. I do not. I only do level requests when the title says level request. Also, when it comes to this level, go is basically 95% because I'm very consistent.
But if you can say it whenever you want, I don't really care.
What? I did that UFO very wrong. Unfortunate. What?
Dude! Needs to look away from the game for a second. And take a drink.
So how's your day? Mine's been very slow. Because I don't got nothing going on. Or rather, I haven't had to be out of the house. I've had to do other stuff. But I haven't had to leave. You woke up and did your hair and made tea, and that's about it so far? Hilarious. Really close. I don't know why I thought I was gonna be upside down there. I was like, okay, I'll just let it like bump me up, and then I'll go over the thing. When it's
holy shit!
Can't wait to rack your brains trying to think of a single use case for a single variable double integrator. Insane. Everything you Google returns multivariable double integration.
Well. I don't know, ChatGPT it. Probably ask ChatGPT for, like, some places you can look for that information. That's typically what I've been doing for school lately, and it's been working out. Instead of having to look for sources myself, I'm just like, hey, where are some good places I can look for sources? Give me some scholarly articles on fucking whatever. You're not touching ChatGPT. What is that? It's useful. It's useful for finding stuff. I didn't until this year, and ever since I started, it's made, like, finding shit a lot easier. I don't ask it for, like, factual information because I don't trust it to give me accurate information, but when it comes to, like, finding things, I mean, it works. You gotta word it properly, though. Otherwise, it'll say, like, I don't have all of the knowledge necessary for this. And I'm like, I'm not asking you for it. I'm asking you where I can get it. you absolutely despise AI. What's the point when it comes to, like, doing your homework? I think AI is a useful tool. I don't like it when people use it for art, but ChatGPT is not used for art. ChatGPT is just kind of there. I see it as a helpful tool. That's about it. And that's what AI should be seen as. Books are a form of art, but you're not using it for creative writing, Solsta. ChatGPT is terrible at creative writing. Have you ever seen anybody try to use it for creative writing? It's the most soulless shit you've ever read. Lie straight through its teeth. So are people! ChatGPT lies less than the average human being, I know that much. It only lies when a human being instructs it to do a thing under any circumstances, which includes lying, which is where the lying story happened. It can't do anything on its own. That's how it's built. I have nothing against AIs. I have everything against AI bros.
People have accountability. ChatGPT will just make up quotes and sources if it can't find any. That's why you fact check.
If it gives you a source that doesn't exist, it's pretty easy to, like, look up the source and see that it doesn't exist. And then you just tell ChatGPT, no, I need something else, and then I'll spit out something else, and you keep doing that until it works. It's an imperfect piece of technology, but it works eventually, unless you're trying to search for, like, I don't know, the recipe for meth. That's why I don't ask it for information. I ask it where to find information. Because then I get my information from, like, actual people who are experts in their field. I entered that portal real weird. Yeah, I just really don't like AI bros. AI bros are like the worst thing ever. Have I tried to Google anything recently? Yeah, that's run off of like one of Google's AIs, and it's not working. Like, it is not working. Actually terrible. Half the searches are just plagued with the AI-generated sludge. That means, yes, it's not working. People are trying to lean too far into AI for things that it shouldn't be used for, I think. Instead of replacing their entire search model with AI, I think they should have just added it as, like, a supplement. Like a little guy in the corner that you can be like, hey, here's like a specific string. Can you direct me to like proper search terms to find this? And then it'll do that. But instead they're trying to like completely turn the entire system into AI, which is not working. AI is not as reliable as they think. It's only reliable as like a supplementary thing. AI-generated ad farm? Yeah, I know. Google is... Okay. Google is being really bad with their AI, is the most general point I'm trying to make. And I mean, it's not surprising. It's fucking Google. They've been making terrible business decisions for a while. Like, it is... It's real bad. Like, I tried to fucking Google help for my CLI for a CCNA lab, right? I was literally just trying to Google, like, what a command was, right? Because I was like, oh, how do I turn on... Because, okay. I was supposed to be... sniffing the network for telnet connections, right? And but I had to set up a telnet connection myself. But I had no idea how to do that because, fun fact, they're just set up by default because they are not secure. You're supposed to, like, take them off. So I didn't fucking know how to set up a telnet connection. But fucking Windows 12 is going to be powered with AI. I fucking... How? In what way? I can't think of anything that, like, would... What the... Okay. Anyway, But yeah, I was just looking up, like, how do I establish a telnet connection to sniff the network for it? And it pulls up the most asinine shit I've ever seen in my entire life, and, like, 27 ads. I'm like, dude. It's like... Just tell me that telnet is the default. I did get that information eventually. Because I thought that, telnet had just been, like, removed. And secure shell was the default. But you have to set up secure shell, so I was kind of being stupid. But telnet is so actually terrible that I didn't think that it would be on the switches natively. So I was looking up how to set it up. It could have just said, oh, that's the default, you don't have to do anything. Instead, it gave me, like, a bunch of directions that I read into it, and it would have locked me out of my switch. Like, because I was supposed to be finding a user, the admin login password. That's what I was looking for. And it told me to log in local on the console line. And then exit. Which, if you don't know, makes it so that it will prompt you for a username and a password upon trying to get into the switch. A username and password which are not set and therefore do not exist. So it bricks the switch. Well, it doesn't brick it, but it makes it so, like, you have, if you save that to running config, then it fucking completely locks up the switch. Or, I mean, startup config. Then it completely locks the switch. You can't do anything. I was like, dude, what are these motherfuckers trying to get me to do? Like, the only way that you can possibly get back into the switch after that is to not save it, and then to unplug the switch. You can't even issue a reload command. God damn it. It's so funny. Hey, I know how to break a switch now. Let's go. Aren't you just in, like, a general computer science degree, Sosa? I am in Python right now. I'm learning Python. I was gonna learn it on my own, and then I found out that it was just a course that was required for the fucking degree, so I was like, you know what, fuck it. Why not? I already know a bit about coding anyway, because I know some C#. So, like, all of these beginning assignments have been really easy for me. Because it's just like, what is... It's just terminology. It's like... What do you call it when you go to the next blank or something in the thing? And I'm like... Line? It says it in the program. What are you waffling on about? My god. What? Okay. I feel like it'd be doing a lot better if this level actually gave me nerves. Because then it would, like, make me pay attention. Instead of just zoning out. Again, I don't know what did that. I don't know if I hit the ground or the little fireballs. I was way too low. My god.
What? What the fuck? How'd I do that? Damn it. I felt really comfortable at the end and I just fudged it.
That's not how you're supposed to do it.
I don't know why I started spamming. What the fuck? So many new ways to die. They call me the adventurer, the discoverer. I went too far down in that portal, so my momentum just kept going, as expected. Oops. God, it gets really hard to see when you're staring at all this white for so fucking long. Thank you.
What?
I went slightly too high, I think. Like, out of the portal? Maybe?
Weird ass transition. I need to rest my hand for a second. God. Excuse me. My wrist is stiff. This level is very clicky. All right. What the fuck?
Oh, my eyes.
My eyes are getting so fucking hazy.
Oh, your eyelids are getting heavier. Oh, you're feeling so sleepy.
What? I am flabbergasted. What? Now I'm really flabbergasted. What the fuck?
Again? I always click too early. It's because the song is slightly off there. You have to click a little later. Gotta keep that in mind for next time. Oh, the bug. Love the bug. Hole. Oh, my eyes are getting bad. Oh, what the fuck?
I gotta sit up in my gamer chair. Gotta get the gamer lean going. I clicked it too late. Come on. Oh. Wow. Am I that bad at wave? Like, it's not that hard. I am flabbergasted. Dude, come on. I'm not this bad at wave, I swear. God, my wrist hurts. Sketchy ass ball. I forgot that you had to put the black one. My bad. Too fast. I knew it was too fast when I did it. Huh? Okay, I'm gonna go into Parex mode. I'm gonna play that last cube. Just to make sure I don't die there again, because I've died there twice, and I would like to not do that. The wave is just a matter of whether or not I can see my goddamn screen. Because my eyes will just unfocus. Let me get a good setup for this dual ship, actually. I think I got enough. Hopefully I clear map. Oops. How is map clear when I can't see through it? Got a little bit of frame stutter. What the fart? Too early. God, that UFO hurts my thingy. Dude. I for gore. I can't believe it. I was feeling so confident too. I was like, I know exactly where to go, and then I just automatically clicked the orb. Goddamn intuition, always fucking things up for me. Constantly fighting against my intuition. I'm physically holding my finger back from clicking, and it just doesn't work sometimes. I beat it. I did the level. Let's go. GG. That is a good level. Do not drink water with spearmint gum in your mouth. Worst mistake of my life. Wintergreen's kinda worse, actually. Oh, you leave. That's what happened to Jack when I beat Sonic Wave. Good level for me, A2 clear. $1,800. All right, what do I want to do now? There's a bug in my room.
Got it!
Bouge. A bed bouge. What the fuck? Richard. Okay, I think I'm going to end stream. Goodbye, everybody. Excuse me.